He disliked the god from the machine, because he was from a machine. But even without the machine he tended to dislike the god, because a god is more general than a man. His enemies have accused Shaw of being anti-domestic, a shaker of the roof tree. But in this sense Shaw may be called almost madly domestic. He wishes each private problem to be settled in private without reference to sociological ethics, and the only objection to this kind of gigantic casuistry is that the theatre is really too small to discuss it. It would not be fair to play David and Goliath on a stage too small to admit Goliath, and it is not fair to discuss private morality on a stage too small to admit the enormous presence of public morality, that character which has not appeared in a play since the Middle Ages, whose name is every man, and whose honor we have all in our keeping. End of Section 6, Chapter 4.
Section 7, Chapter 5, Part 1. The Dramatist. No one who was alive at the time and interested in such matters will ever forget the first acting of Arms in the Man. It was applauded by that indescribable element in all of us which rejoices to see the genuine thing prevail against the plausible, that element which rejoices that even its enemies are alive. Apart from the problems raised in the play, the very form of it was an attractive and forcible innovation. Classic plays which were wholly heroic, comic plays which were wholly and even heartlessly ironical, were common enough. Commonest of all in this particular time was the play that began playfully, with plenty of comic business, and was gradually sobered by sentiment until it ended on a note of romance or even pathos. A commonplace little officer, the butt of the mess, becomes by the last act as high and hopeless a lover as Dante, or a vulgar and violent pork butcher remembers his own youth before the curtain goes down. The first thing that Bernard Shaw did when he stepped before the footlights was to reverse this process. He resolved to build a play not on pathos, but on bathos. The officer should be heroic first, and then everyone should laugh at him. The curtain should go up on a man remembering his youth, and he should only reveal himself as a violent pork butcher when someone interrupted him with an order for pork. This merely technical originality is indicated in the very title of the play. The arma vermique of Virgil is a mounting and ascending phrase. The man is more than his weapons. The Latin line suggests a superb procession which should bring on to the stage the brazen and resounding armor, the shield and shattering axe, but end with the hero himself taller and more terrible because unarmed. The technical effect of Shaw's scheme is like the same scene in which a crowd should carry even more gigantic shapes of shield and helmet, but when the horns and howls were at their highest, should end with the figure of Little Tick. The name itself is meant to be a bathos, arms, and the man.